Hey Internet, Caligula here, and welcome to a very special build! So today I am building The Raven, which is a hotel that appears in the Netflix series Altered Carbon. So in this video, I will get into spoiler territory about the series. However, I will save the spoilers for the end of the video, and in the beginning, just give you a general spoiler-free summary of the plot and its characters. That way, if you haven't seen the show, but you're still interested in this build, you can know what I'm building without me totally spoiling the show for you. Also, I will make it very clear when the spoiler part of the video is about to begin, so you can pause the video before you actually hear any spoilers. Also, I apologize in advance if I talk really fast in this video. I had an iced coffee a little while ago and, yeah, that's where we are now. So anyway, let me first tell you a little bit about Altered Carbon, then I'll talk more about the build itself, and then I will talk more about what I thought about the show, what I liked, what I didn't like, that sort of thing. It's a really great show, especially if you're into science fiction, and I highly recommend it, even though there were some things about it that I didn't like. But anyway, here's what Altered Carbon is all about. So Altered Carbon is a science fiction story that takes place in the near future in a world where people have figured out how to upload and download souls onto digital drives called stacks. Stacks look like vertebrae, and they're implanted in the spine, at the base of the neck. So in Altered Carbon, it's possible to live forever, because stacks can be implanted into different bodies, which are what they call sleeves. Also, what they call real death is still possible, but only if a person's stack is destroyed. So their body can be destroyed, but their soul can still live on and be put into a new body. But not if the stack itself is destroyed. The problem is that sleeves are really expensive. So you can get a new sleeve by implanting your stack into the body of a criminal who was sentenced to real death, or into the body of someone whose stack was destroyed when they died but whose body was still salvageable, or you can create a new body by cloning yourself or another person. But the better the sleeve, the more expensive it is. So only the super rich in this world end up living forever, since they are the only ones who could really afford to make clones of themselves. So the story of Altered Carbon is about a man named Takeshi Kovacs, who was a specially trained soldier called an envoy. Envoys were soldiers who went through special training that taught them how to quickly accustom to new sleeves. A lot of people in this world have problems when they're first implanted into new sleeves. They feel really nauseous for a long time and disoriented because they're in a completely new body, and for some reason the upload-download process really affects them physically in that way. But not envoys. Envoys are super accustomed to being implanted into new sleeves. They're also specially trained to withstand physical and psychological torture, and they were also given sleeves that were specially juiced up with heightened senses and intuition. So sometime before the story of Altered Carbon actually begins, the envoys rebelled against the meths. The meths are what they call the super rich, the people who live forever. I think they get that name from a biblical character named Methuselah or something like that. He was someone in the Old Testament who lived for like 900 to 1,000 years, something like that. But anyway, at some point the envoys rebelled against the meths, and they tried to make it so that re-sleeving was more equitable and not just for the super rich. However, eventually the envoy rebellion was crushed, and Takeshi Kovacs was the only envoy whose stack remained intact. So the story of Altered Carbon begins, I think, like 200 years after the envoy rebellion was crushed, when Kovacs is re-sleeved by the order of a meth named Lawrence Bancroft. Lawrence Bancroft wants Kovacs re-sleeved because Bancroft was actually murdered, and he wants Kovacs to solve his murder for him. By the way, Bancroft is played by, if you've seen Rome, the same guy that plays Antony, and the very first time you see him in Altered Carbon, how can I put this delicately? He hangs dong. And it's totally unnecessary. He just walks into a room completely naked and then immediately puts on a robe. But, so there's that. Yeah, that's one thing about Altered Carbon that's kind of cool. There's a lot of nudity, kind of like Game of Thrones, a lot of nudity, a lot of violence, but at least it's equal nudity. So you see just as many penises as you do boobs. But anyway. So Bancroft's stack was destroyed when he was murdered, but he still lives because he had a digital copy of his stack backed up to an external drive every 48 hours, which is also why he doesn't remember who murdered him. So when Kovacs hears about his assignment, he is not at all interested. He is still an envoy at heart. He still hates the Meths, and he's just not interested at all in this assignment, and he immediately turns it down. But Bancroft tells him to take 24 hours to, you know, experience the world again and go out and do whatever he wants and decide if he wants to stay in a sleeve or if he wants to go back on ice. So when Bancroft gives Kovacs his 24 hours, Kovacs decides that he's going to use that 24 hours to do a bunch of drugs and bang a bunch of prostitutes. By the way, Kovacs is played, he's actually played by two different actors, which is a little confusing. One actor plays Kovacs in a past life in Kovacs's original body, and the other actor, whose name is Joel Kinnaman, plays Kovacs in his new sleeve. But my God, Joel Kinnaman is such a beautiful man. He's just this enormous, muscular Swedish man, and he's got such a alluring toot in the series that, I'm sad that the show is over for me. I'm sad that I finished watching the whole thing, partly just because I'm sad that I don't get to see Joel Kinnaman walk around every day. But anyway, so while Kovacs is drugged up, he wanders into a hotel called The Raven, which is run by an AI obsessed with Edgar Allan Poe. So Poe is probably my favorite character in the series. He's just, he's an AI who is obviously like very lonely, but very in love with humanity and poetry. And he makes himself look exactly like Edgar Allan Poe. And he also turns his hotel into this weird half digital, half Victorian, macabre sort of place. So because I like Poe's character so much, and because The Raven itself is a really interesting mix of styles, I really wanted to try to build it in The Sims. So that's what I'm doing here today. So I spent the majority of this build working on the lobby. So there were a couple of very important things that I wanted to include in the lobby. The first thing were those gigantic arches. Another thing that was important to me to recreate in this lobby area was the floor. So in Altered Carbon, the floor tile that's used is actually the same one that The Sims has, that tiled pattern with the three different shades, the blue, the red, and the tan. The problem is, in Altered Carbon, the tile, each square of the tile is just on a much bigger scale. And so here it looks pretty busy. And so I didn't feel like I could cover the whole floor with that tiling. It looked like way too much. So I decided to outline the floor in a black marble just to mute it down a little. I also wanted to include some sort of pattern in the middle of the floor. So in Altered Carbon, that pattern is just made out of those abstract geometric tiles. However, because the print is so small in The Sims, I couldn't really recreate that. So I decided to just use a couple different floorings instead. And I think that it turned out really well. So you saw me before experimenting with a couple different woods, and I ended up putting this diamond. And I thought that looked pretty good, but then I stopped for a while and took a break from building. I think I just like ate dinner or something. And I came back and I thought, well, I'm probably not going to be able to do anything better, but I do want to experiment a little bit more with creating a floor centerpiece. So I just started messing around with it. The way that you create patterns, by the way, is you use two commands. The first is Control F, and that allows you to place triangles rather than whole squares of tile. And the other is Control, and then the arrow key, the one that looks like a caret or a greater than, less than sign, which allows you to actually rotate the direction of the tile. I discovered those two tools recently, and so that's why it took me a lot of experimentation to make something good. And so, I didn't figure that I would, do something much better than what I had originally, but then I ended up actually surprising myself. So I apologize for not recording that, but I do really like how it looked in the end. Another thing that I really wanted to capture in the lobby, but that didn't quite work out, was the wallpaper. So in The Raven, there is this really cool looking wallpaper that looks exactly like that digital wallpaper that we have in The Sims, except the digital pieces are actually little ravens that are kind of breaking free from blocks, if that makes any sense at all. And so the wallpaper that we have in The Sims is so close to what I needed for this build, but I couldn't put it in there because it had a white trim, and that white trim just really didn't look right with the rest of the interior of this lobby. So yeah, the most important things that I wanted to include in the lobby of this build were, well, first of all, the blue windows that peek through parts of the lobby. Secondly, the floor tiles. Thirdly, those giant arches, which they look pretty good, although you can still see because I sized them up, you could still see the shadows of the original sizes, which is pretty annoying. It's pretty annoying, but it bothered me less and less the more I started to fill the lobby with stuff. They seemed to be not quite so noticeable once there were other things in the lobby and it wasn't so bare. And then, yeah, what else did I want to include? Oh, I wanted to include the wallpaper, but yeah, that didn't quite work out. But I think that these two-toned red ones look pretty cool. I think they're both from the vampire stuff pack, at least the one with the bats at the top of the lobby is. And I think that looks pretty convincing. It's in the same spirit as the wallpaper that I really wanted to use. It's not quite that mix of digital and macabre that I was really hoping for. So the biggest struggle I had with this lobby were, first of all, those dang arches, because it was so hard to place them without getting them to clip to a wall, because if they clip to a wall, then the outline that they create is still the outline that's the arch's original size. It doesn't actually size up the cutout of the wall in the same way that when you try to size up windows or something, like the window holes remain the same size that they were before. It's just the frame that gets bigger. So trying to place those arches, It gave me such a headache. And there were a few points when building this where when I realized that I would have to move the arches around, I was just like, ugh, I'll come back to this later. You'll see that a couple times when I start furnishing the upstairs. But another thing that I had trouble with in this lobby was just filling it up, because it's such an enormous space. It's the size of the entire lot. So it's just huge. And trying to figure out how to make such a space still seem, you know, like big and spacious, but also like it's compartmentalized and makes sense, was kind of a struggle. So I knew that I would need to use rugs in order to make it feel like the furnishings were actually organized and like they had a specific spot. And I also thought that segmenting off that middle section of the floor would help a lot too. But the thing that helped fill this lobby up and that made it not feel so empty were the plants. Once I start bringing plants into this lobby, that is when things really start coming together. I was really happy that I found that bear in debug mode, because in the original there is a big scary looking bear, and even though this one is made of wood, I just think it's so cute and so funny. And honestly, I think I did a really, really good job of recreating the raven, at least in the lobby part of this build. It's not quite as accurate once we get to the upstairs. I'll talk more about that when we get there. But yeah, I think I did a really good job with the lobby. I included the bear, I included the grandfather clock, I included a similar style of flooring, the bar is in the right place, although you should know that there's not actually a functional bar at the bar, it's just countertops because I needed the bar to be U-shaped and I couldn't find a bar that was the same color as the countertops. I couldn't find one that just blended in, so it's a pretend bar. There's not actually a bar there. But yeah, you could see me now bringing in all these plants. What I did was, in order to make it feel cohesive and also in order to just make it a little bit easier for myself, I only used a handful of plants and I just played around with sizing them up and changing the color of the pots to bring in some diversity. But I really wanted to use plants that looked a little more, I guess, Mediterranean. A lot of the ones that I used are from the Jungle Adventure stuff pack, and I wanted to use those because, I don't know, that's the vibe of the plants that are in the original. They're like almost this sort of tropical vibe. So yeah, I just take a handful of plants, change up the pots that they're in, and just place them everywhere. And like I said, once I start bringing the plants in, that's when I feel like the build really starts to come together. You can also see that I have those cute little winged llamas, the scary winged llamas, on that table in the front. I think that table in the original is actually in front of the bar area of the lobby, but the middle space of the lobby that I've created here just felt so empty, so I decided to put it there instead. It was also pretty difficult to make this room not look so dark. So part of the reason for that was because this room is actually two stories tall. And so, you know, in The Sims, if you raise up a light to the second story, the light doesn't actually quite spill over down onto the floor below. So I had to use a ton of sconces. I think at least three chandeliers. No, five chandeliers. And a ton of candelabras and floor lamps just to make this room look illuminated. So yeah, it looks pretty dark for a while, but once I start putting in, well, namely like the lamps and the candles, it starts to look a lot better. By the way, it's just started raining, so you're probably gonna hear a little bit of rain in the background here. I'm sorry about that. I can't control the weather. It's been raining every day for like a week straight where I live, so. It may not be doing much for the recording, but at least it kind of sets the tone of the build that we've got going on here. Oh yeah, it started pouring. Yep. Well, I hope you don't mind that it started pouring. I'll try to make this quick. Oh yeah, that was another thing that I did, was I used those wall dividers. I forget where they're from, maybe the Vintage Glamour stuff pack, and I just raised them up to create this cool sculpture on the inside of the arches. And I really love that because that's almost exactly what it looks like on the interior of the Raven, and I'm so happy that it worked out so well. And also, I'm really happy that those were actually pretty easy to place and raise up. Okay, so it has really started to pour down rain now, so I think I'm gonna stop this recording for now, but I will catch you back later for the upstairs. Hey, I'm back. It's actually the next day. It rained pretty much all night last night, so after a couple hours, I just decided to give up for the day and to record the rest of this voiceover today. So before we move on to the upstairs, I work on the actual stairs of this building for a while. It was kind of annoying to have to include stairs in this build. I wish we had functional elevators in the game. I know there's that functional elevator mod, but I didn't really want to use a mod to make a build usable because then that would make this building much less downloadable. So I decided to just use stairs in the end. You see me now applying the glow that flows wall texture to the front of the build. So the reason why I used that wall texture and the reason why I put in another wall right outside of the front wall of the building, if that makes any sense. You know what I'm talking about? I had to put in another wall in order to be able to apply that wall texture. The reason I decided to do that was because in the Raven, on the outside, all of the windows kind of have this red glow. And I originally thought about just having, you know, the windows there, and by creating that red glow by putting in some directional lights. I think I was going to try to use the art lighting and just turn the shade of that lighting to a red shade. But when I was experimenting with that off camera, you just couldn't see the red lighting that much. So that's why I decided to use the glow that flows wallpaper instead. But that had its own consequences as well. So it made the front of the build look super cool. But it also made me have to include a really, really tiny hallway upstairs that's super annoying. So now that we're working on the upstairs, you could see that hallway a little bit more now. So the staircase area is 3 squares wide. And the hallway was originally 3 squares wide too. It was still a really long hallway that extended the whole width of the building. But after I added in that the glow that flows wallpaper, I realized that I also had to make that hallway only 2 squares wide. So I know it's not a big deal, but it was really bothering me because if it were a long hallway that were, you know, a good width, a reasonable width, it wouldn't look so weird, but as a 2 square wide hallway, it really annoys me. But I just had to bite the bullet and go with it and call that one of the sacrifices that I had to make for the sake of the exterior. I think it was worth that sacrifice to have such a cool exterior, but it's still one part of this build that really annoys me. So I'm not going to talk too much about the bedroom because, well, there's not that much to say. I just tried to recreate screenshots that I had taken of the show while I was watching it. So that's what you see me doing here. There was a bed area in each bedroom. There was a bar area, a fireplace, and then a balcony as well. So you actually only see Kovach's bedroom in altered carbon. You don't see any other bedrooms that are in the Raven. There may not be any other bedrooms. I don't know. I think that Kovach was the first guest that Poe had to at his hotel in 50 years or something like that. So there may not be any other bedrooms. But I had space for four of them once I figured out exactly how big I wanted the first bedroom to be. I had space for four of them. So I end up including four. But yeah, there was that problem of the hallway and how to actually access the four bedrooms. So that's a little weird. All of the bedrooms are decorated in exactly the same style with pretty much exactly the same furnishings. I just change up the color swatches in the four bedrooms, so there's a little bit of variation. So this room has more of like a purple and a gray sort of vibe. There's another bedroom that is very red, another that is more like blacks and tans, and I forget what the other one is. I think it's more blue, maybe? Actually, I think it's black and gray. And then there's another one that's tan and gray. I don't know. You'll see it. You'll see it in the machinima that I have for you at the end. So that's pretty much all there is to say about the bedrooms. I just tried to recreate them as accurately as I possibly could. And I think I did, overall, a pretty good job of that. Although, I don't think that I did as good of a job recreating the bedrooms as I did with the lobby downstairs. So each bedroom also has its own bathroom. I think there's only one time when we see Kovach in his hotel bathroom in the entire season of Altered Carbon. So I had very, very little to go off of. So I just tried to, you know, play off of what was given to me, which was a shower with black tiling and very big glass shower doors. So that's what I created. I actually think that the bathrooms in this build are pretty cool. I would really enjoy bathrooms like that in my house. So this is the part of the build where I'm going to talk about my opinions on Altered Carbon, what I liked about the series, what I didn't like. So that means that this is also the part of the video where I'm going to get into spoiler territory. So if you don't want to hear any spoilers about Altered Carbon, then you need to turn back in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, so here's what I think. So I loved Altered Carbon. It was one of my favorite shows that I've ever watched. Part of the reason why is because I'm a diehard science fiction fan, and so if there is a science fiction series that's got a really great premise and a really great universe, I'm probably going to really like it. And I think that that is something that Altered Carbon definitely has, for sure. The whole idea of stacks and real death and sleeves, I think it's just so original and so very cool, and I think it also presents a really interesting question about whether or not we should live forever if we have that opportunity, because I think that that's one of the things that the show explores. It explores the idea of the longer you live, maybe the more likely it is that you will lose elements of your humanity, because death is something that makes humans humans, and the knowledge that we will die one day. At least, that's what I think. But yeah, so I loved the premise of the series. I thought the premise was genius. And I love the series so much that, if you didn't already know, Altered Carbon is the first in a 3-part book series. I'm definitely gonna read it, absolutely. And I hope that it is as good as the show. I really hope it is, because I really enjoyed it. So having said that, there were definitely some things about Altered Carbon that I did not like. Honestly, not that many though. So the main thing that I did not like about the show was how confusing the plot was. The plot was so confusing. Like, You know, I like to think that I am a smart woman, but dang, I had no idea what was happening for like the first two episodes. I was just kind of so intrigued by the premise and by, you know, the visuals of the series that I kept watching, even though I didn't really know what was going on. And the thing that made it so confusing is that there were so many different strands of the plot that were presented at once, and they do all connect at the end, but when they're presented in such a disjointed way, it's just hard to see how they're connected. And I know that that's kind of the point, but yeah, you know, it makes it hard to follow. And I feel like Altered Carbon probably doesn't have as many viewers because the plot is so confusing in the beginning. So instead of just claiming that it's confusing, I should give an example, right? So one thing that was super confusing was the fact that there are two actors who play Takeshi Kovacs. It's just super confusing that there are two actors who play the same man, and it makes sense why there are two different actors, because Kovacs lives his life in two different sleeves, or more different sleeves, and one is his original sleeve and one is the one he's in at present. Yeah, I get it, it makes sense. But for the longest time, I had no idea that those two actors were supposed to be playing the same person. And I don't know why exactly it didn't occur to me that those two people weren't the same person, or why I didn't get it. I feel like it wasn't made very clear. At least that's my opinion. Another thing that I found confusing that was sort of related to the plot were a couple of the visuals that were supposed to be a running thread throughout the series. For instance, in the title sequence, the main visual that you see is like this dragon, and in the first episode, Kovacs gets that tattoo of a dragon on his forearm, and his sister also has a tattoo of a dragon on her head. But I didn't understand really like what that dragon tattoo has to do with the series. I assume that it's supposed to be something that unites those two and that's somehow related to their culture on the planet that they grew up on. But yeah, I didn't get it. And I wasn't sure why that was supposed to be such a strong visual element that was so important enough to be included in the title sequence. So yeah, the plot was confusing, and some of the visuals that were meant to actually unite the plot or to go along with it were confusing as well, because the connection between them just, it wasn't clear. It wasn't clear, at least in my opinion. Another thing that I did not like about the series was the character of the female cop. I liked her towards the end after she got her cool robot arm, but in the first few episodes, she's just such a overbearing nag, and it's just so annoying, and like her story makes sense, but I don't know, in my opinion, her character seems like the kind of powerful female character that a man would write, you know? A man thinks that every woman who is in a position of authority is going to be, like, always trying to, like, bolster up her authority by being, you know, like, super bitchy and that sort of thing. And that just isn't true. Like, for instance, contrast her character with the character of Kovacs' sister. Like, her character is a really cool villain, and she doesn't have, like, that nagging personality that the female cop does. So the female cop's character really bothered me, and yeah, I get it, but I think that her character is something that would turn people away from the series, which is disappointing because, you know, it is overall a really great series. So those are my opinions about the show. By far, my favorite scene in the entire show was the naked cologne fight with the female cop and Kovacs' sister. That scene, it was just so badass, so cool. The naked clone katana sword fight, yeah, that's my jam. But we're coming now to the end of this video, so I've got to stop gushing on about the series. I really hope that you enjoyed this build. Let me know what you think about this build in the comments below. Let me know what you would like me to recreate next. Honestly, these are my favorite kinds of builds. Builds in which I recreate sets that I've seen on TV. So if there's a show that you really think that I would like and that has a set in it that I ought to create, let me know what that is. I have a couple of build ideas, recreation build ideas up my sleeve at the moment, so It may take me a while to get around to your suggestions, but I'll definitely consider them. And I'm always looking for new TV shows to watch because I love my TV. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope that you enjoyed it, and I will talk to you in another video very soon. Goodbye!